helped him out.
But, excuse me. Who are you?
I'm Keely's sister. I was standing right back there, and I saw that boy's mama give him the letter G. She was saying G.
Smoking on the blood. Bust my gun.
Damn, nigga, she all up in your nut.
Uh-huh. Up in your nut and cracking it.
What's she doing? Two-stepping?
Surfing the avenue. Mad at you.
Move.
Remind me again why we tolerate them?
Because they gave you a Prada bag for your birthday.
Hey guys, welcome back to another dope episode of On the Scene. Let me introduce you to our next amazing and talented guest. We have actress, writer, producer, Erica Hubbard. Hey girl.
Hey.
Hey. And I got my other girl here, actress Chandra, who's co-hosting with
What's
me tonight.
Up,
hey girl.
Hey.
Hey, hey, hey. So, Chandra, I'm going to let you start off tonight.
She's going to let me start off tonight.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, she said.
Then I'll jump
so
in.
So, we have the phenomenal Erica Hubbard. And
yes.
First, let me say, true fan, I'm going to give my starstruck out first. True mm-hmm. fan, you're an amazing actress, love everything that you do. So, with that being said, can you tell us, when did you start? And, What was the determining factor that this is what I want to do?
Good question.
Ooh. Well, thanks for having me on the scene.
You're welcome.
I really appreciate it. In my hometown of Chicago.
Yes.
As a Chicago. So when I first started, it was 8 or 9. I had some stage parents.
Okay.
And they're like, you're going to start doing this. And mm-hmm. I'm like, start doing what? Like posing, smiling. And so I was like programmed uh-huh. as a little kid to smile, pose, entertain, you know.
Okay.
And I was like, okay, well, I like this because I like to smile and I like to talk. And I'm an extrovert. So it worked for me naturally. So
nice.
It just seemed like it was forced after a while. And then the determining factor when I was like, oh, I like this,
mm-hmm.
because it was a hobby to me, even though I was making money.
Mm-hmm.
It still was fun. Mm-hmm. So to me, it was just a hobby. But then when I started making money, I was like, oh, this is a career. This is
there
a determining
go.
Factor. As you would call it. I was like, this is nice, you know, because then I had a little shopping problem.
Oh.
Yeah. So that helped with my shopping addiction. It still does.
Mm-hmm.
The checks and stuff. So. You know, so I like to hear my doorbell ring, and then it's a package for you. I got that bad.
Mm.
Sometimes 2-3 times a day. Okay, I'm getting off topic.
Okay.
But it was like when I was like 18.
Okay.
And then my parents were like, okay, so you really want to pursue this
mm-hmm.
professionally? Because
mm-hmm.
I'd already been in SAG-AFTRA since I was 8 or 9 years old.
Oh, wow.
So, okay. Yeah, I've been in since the 90s, you know. And I was like, yeah, I really do want to pursue this professionally. So I'm going to Hollywood. Because, you know, I had a friend on a Nickelodeon show, and she went right to Hollywood at 18.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to follow her, and they were like, no, you're not following her.
Oh, wow.
And I'm like, wait, what? You can do it professionally here in Chicago. And I'm like, wait, huh? But it's not Hollywood. So, but I'm glad they made that decision for me because I got to train at Columbia College.
Okay.
And I started training with people from Steppenwolf, Goodman Theater,
nice.
Looking Glass, Second City, Improv Olympic, people coming in from Groundlings.
Mm-hmm.
And so that helped me at Columbia College
mm-hmm.
train there.
Okay.
And so after I got the college degree,
mm-hmm.
I was like, okay, it's time for me to go to Hollywood, you know? And they were like, okay, you can go to Hollywood. So when I went to Hollywood, I was ready for them because I was a stage actor. And I
mm-hmm.
think the true thespian, I was on it. Like, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
You train on theater versus
mm-hmm.
people who just have the TV and film. No disrespect, but
mm-hmm.
it is different.
Mm-hmm. That's what I've heard.
Mm-hmm.
So would you recommend that all artists do something in theater? Yes, definitely.
I put my whole head into that. I didn't do it like this. I said,
yes.
Because when you train on the stage,
mm-hmm.
it's using a muscle.
Mm-hmm.
That you're working out in there, and it has a disciplined skill set in there, and you can't have a take 2, take 3.
Mm.
So your whole body is geared up to get it right, and you know what those nerves feel like, you know? Oh, yeah. And that's the biggest thing. Because TV and film, people are like, oh, I'm so nervous. You just, come on now, you could stop and do it again and stop. And But theater, you got the audience looking right at you. You can feel the energy. You got those lines in your head, and you better say those lines right, because they will be good as hell.
There's no take two.
And I like that. I like that discipline. And I'm an NAACP theater nominated actress. Thank you. And I know that it takes a different type of training to do that versus, okay, I'm going to say this line and I hope I say it right. You know, I'm going to say it this way, you know. So, okay.
Now, which do you prefer? Do you prefer theater or do you prefer TV and film?
I prefer it all.
Okay.
I prefer it all because I love performing, you know, whether it's comedy or drama, whether it's television, film, or so, you know, webisode, short film. I just love the art of performing different characters and bringing roles to life. Amazing. You know, give me something crazy and I'll try to tackle it. You know, so I've been fortunate enough to play different roles from the nerd, the groupie girl, to the wife, to the cheater, to the doctor, to the stripper, to the, I mean, it's just all kinds of stuff that I get to dig into all these different characters and bring them to life.
And you killed them all.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, let me tell you, killed them all. Let's talk about Hyde Park that you did an amazing job in. Starring Kenneth, is it Okoli? Okoli and Don Half Kenny. So, and I was in there as a background in the wedding scene. Amazing movie. Go see it. It is at Studio Movie Grill. Go see it, y'all. So tell us about that role, Erica.
Well, Aja is a character where she's outspoken. She kind of gives her friend a lot of advice about how to pick a man and what to look for in a man. And it was fun playing that role, you know? It was hard work. I mean, I don't know what to look for in a man to pick a man. I had to do a lot of character research and development because I'm like, oh, she's sure of herself. But me as a person, I'm still trying to figure out what do you look for in here? Resting as for a guy. And how do you know? So I learned a lot from the character because she had her bullet points on, you know, shoe sizes or whatever.
Okay, let me, you know. It was amazing. Yeah. You did a good job.
Thank you.
A great job. A great job. So what advice would you give to upcoming actresses?
Ooh, what advice would I give to upcoming actresses would be, so don't feel like you're not working if you don't book something on TV and film. You're always working. When you pick up a play and you read the play, when you memorize a monologue, that's work. When you train with acting coaches or dialect coaches, that's work. So you have to put in the work because when you get on the platform to display your talent, people know how much work you put into it already.
There you go.
So you have to do the work in order to get the work, you know, and don't be, you can't be lazy about it. There There's days where I just pick up a monologue book and I'm just in the mirror and just reading it and saying the lines, you know, and it's called honing your skill.
There you go.
You know, a lot of people don't use this word anymore, but working on your craft.
Yep.
Yeah. I want people to go back to those days where I'm working on my craft because people, you know, so work on your craft.
There you go. Gems, y'all. Now, do you give classes? Do you teach classes at all?
I do. I do. You know, private coaching. I really do. I was fortunate enough to teach someone close to me. And they went to Tribeca Film Festival. Wow. Their film got picked up. So is my daughter.
Wow.
I coached her for her first role. She booked it, and she was in New York on the red carpet. And she could be Googled now, and she's so excited. You know, that's exciting for her. So, yeah, coached her.
That's amazing. Amazing. Thank you. And who cares in your daughter?
Yeah. That's amazing. I was a little hard on her. I was like, you got it, book this. You got it, do this. Do your exercises. Do your tongue twisters. Come on. Don't be nervous. You know about that, right?
Amazing.
But when it was all said and done, she got a lot of pictures and she was happy. So, you know, she's a little Kiki Palmer in the training. Because, you know, I was with Kiki Palmer for Keelan to be.
Yep.
So I saw it all there and all that. So I was like, we're going to take these techniques and we're going to use it
there
on
you. There you go. So. Amazing. And who better else from her mother? Amazing, talented mother.
Thank you.
Awesome. Okay, I'm sorry, Stefan. Oh. My bad. Oh. I had to just jump in there. Okay.
So you said you had stage parents. So your parents were in the arts as well?
No. No, they think they are. They still think they are. That's when I'm going to the On the Scene podcast interview. They're like, okay, you better do good. What time does this start? All right. I'm like, oh, gosh.
Oh, wow.
They prepped me before I got here. All right. You're on your way. And I was like, whoa. Okay. I'll do good. All right. They're never going to give it up because they're my number one supporters. Yeah. And you have to have that in this industry. Yes. If you do not have that, you will fall by the wayside. Yes. You have to have a support system no matter what you do. Mm-hmm. That big ups. Okay, big ups. Chicago. That's Chicago slang. That cheers you on. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because so it's going to be some times where you're going to be like, what am I doing? Yes. Why am I doing it? You know, so you have to have somebody saying, you know, you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
Keep
mm-hmm.
going. You mm-hmm. got this. And so that's the biggest thing, because some people don't know the art of complimenting. Mm-hmm. And so I right. make sure that my friends and my family who I'm surrounded by, mm-hmm. they edify me. If you're not an edifier, you can't be in my space, because that can make or break your future. Mm. So if you have somebody with a negative spirit, negative energy, yeah. you'll be like, oh, it'll drain you. But if you mm-hmm. have somebody pushing you verbally, yes. you'll grow.
And encouraging yes. you. Mm-hmm. So true.
Like
running the race. Okay,
yeah.
I'm going to get up a time. I'm coming.
Yes. So I'm going to put you on my team. Yeah. yeah. That's exactly.
There you
go. We friends now.
There you go. Yes. It's true.
It's a love language. Everybody doesn't have that, so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That is so amazing. True.
Mm-hmm. That is definitely amazing.
Yeah, you can flourish. You can believe in yourself. You even you got people out here that aren't good acting, but mm-hmm. somebody told them they were good, and they believe it, and they're doing it.
There you go.
So it's just the art of believing, you know? Mm-hmm. So that's like the number one thing is your mindset. Your mm-hmm. mindset can carry you into a wealthy place.
That's very true.
Because if it's not there, you're not going to flourish.
Right.
Yep.
You're going to stay stagnated right yep. there. And you want to do more, but you mm-hmm. can't.
Because you're always second-guessing yourself.
The
yep.
tenacity, the will, the want to
yes.
do.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
And you need that person to push you. Like, come on, mm-hmm. you can do this. That's okay. You might fall.
You
come on, get
down,
back up and
on.
Keep going.
Oh, you're good. Yeah.
Yeah, because we've all been there.
Yeah.
We've all been there.
So let me ask you, in your career, what is the actress or actor that you are like, that's like your shero or hero, someone that you try to model, if any?
Viola Davis.
Yes.
I think she's phenomenal.
Oh my God. Yes.
She reaches depths where you're like, whoa, where did
mm-hmm.
she just go?
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to do that. So I'm in the bathroom, snotting through my nose.
Yes. She played that role, boy.
Ooh, it is just one scene,
yes,
but it was so emotionally
mm-hmm.
available.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a vulnerability a lot of people don't have,
yep.
being emotionally vulnerable
mm-hmm.
and just letting everything loose and taking off the layers and just showing
yes.
who
yes.
you are.
Yes.
And she really did.
Mm-hmm.
I saw her, I had the privilege, let me say that, to see her on Broadway in Fences.
Oh.
And she, it wasn't what she said.
Uh-huh.
It was what she did with her body. Yeah, because it was Russell Hornsby, Denzel Washington, but Viola Davis. Woo! She
amazing.
She had a part in the this one scene. She had a moment.
Because
it's moment to moment.
Mm-hmm.
Where she took the flower and she looked at him. Let me do my Viola. Here go my moment. And she took the flower and she crumbled it.
Mm.
And everybody started going in the audience.
Oh, wow.
Everybody. She just evoked emotion out of everybody crying. We were snotting and everything. And it was
wow.
like, dang, she was just there. So she's just so... what I want to say when you're just honest,
mm-hmm.
phenomenally honest,
because mm-hmm.
everybody's not honest in their work. You can
mm-hmm.
tell who's faking it,
yeah.
and then you could tell her she was really in a place where she was like, I was like, oh, God, what's going to happen? I was like, oh. You know, we was shaking. We was out of there. We was people who didn't have Kleenex. We was doing this. My nose was running. And I was like, wow, I want to be like that.
So since you said that, what do you do to prep for a scene?
Yeah. Ooh, she's trying to get the secret. She's trying to get the secret.
Inside secret show.
Right. You heard it here first.
On the scene.
Yeah. Okay, so you want to know about substitution, mm-hmm. Stanislavski, all that stuff, Uta mm-hmm. Hagen, mm-hmm. Michael Shurtleff audition. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some people do method and they train with the people that they want to portray. Mm-hmm. I've done that before. Mm-hmm. But that's kind of dangerous sometimes. Mm-hmm. You can fall victim. And actually, some of the characters can still stay on you, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. Because if it takes how many days to form a habit? 21. Right. So if you're on a film, mm-hmm. and I've been on a film where we're shooting for like 4 weeks, you can become that character. Mm-hmm. And when you're off, you can't shake that. And mm-hmm. then, when I did a Cinderella story, mm-hmm. I was really like Madison. I was a little had an air about myself and mm-hmm. a little arrogant and talking to people and stuff. And then I realized, why am I doing that? I'm still in character. Mm. And then I didn't work for like a couple of years after that. I was mm-hmm. still in her mode, still portraying her. You know, because mm-hmm. that's what I had been doing for a whole month working on that Warner Brothers film. Wow. So I vowed to myself never to do that. Then I became Cassie on Lincoln Heights, who was totally different than Madison. You mm-hmm. know, she operated in humility. Mm-hmm. So instead of doing method, I switched to just moment to moment, like substitution work, you know. Okay. So if I was in this moment, how would I really feel mm-hmm. or can I go to a place where it would take me there mm-hmm. to get as close to the emotion as I can, you know, okay. that I experienced something that would connect me to this moment.
Okay. Wow. Amazing. Now, let me ask you, have you met Viola Davis at all?
I felt like I met her when I saw her on Broadway in Fences, okay. you know? I felt mm-hmm. like I did, but I didn't meet her personally. I plan to meet her because I want to work with you. I'm manifesting it. I'm going to work with Viola Davis. I'm going to work with my I am.
Hey, you got to manifest. Claim it.
I'm going to work with her. Claim it. Yeah, but Angela Bassett is awesome, too.
Yes.
I had an opportunity to work with her, and nice. She taught me some stuff that stuck with me. And I really do believe I was able to book a lot of roles because of the information she gave me. You know, so in all humility, I appreciate her. Mm-hmm. Her skill set to the utmost.
Amazing.
She's
yeah.
one of my faves.
Yes.
Mm.
Yes.
Mm. So let's talk about. Let's get deep.
Okay. Let's go there.
Glenn Close.
Mm. I love her too.
Oh wow.
Tilda Swinton. Let's talk about her. You know. Mm-hmm. Sally Fields.
Yep.
Yes.
Meryl Streep.
Yes.
So I like to watch everybody. You know, some of the men, too, mm-hmm. you know? Okay. So that's what it is. Watch people and learn. People watch.
Yeah. Yeah.
People watch.
Yes.
You know? I may have to portray you one day.
Hey.
Somebody like you.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes that's the best. Those are the best
mm-hmm.
teachers.
Yes. So true. Mm-hmm. So true. So
you
true.
Watch. Everybody has their different personas, and you just mm-hmm. watch everybody's persona, then you mimic it.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
So you have to have a whole bunch of people in your head to mimic,
mm-hmm.
you know, when it's so time true. To play that role. So you can be there already, pull it in your file, like, oh, I know somebody like that.
Okay,
there sometimes you go. I'll call people up, and they'll talk to me about their personality, what they like, mm-hmm. they don't like, because mm-hmm. I'll use them in a role.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, is there a role, like your ultimate role, that you haven't had a chance to play yet?
I think the ultimate role would be somebody portraying me, my life story.
Ooh.
Because I don't think anybody has really heard my life story before. So I'd like to see somebody kind of portray my life story and write a script. And
hey.
They're going to be like, but she made it though. You know what I mean? My story, growing up on the south side of Chicago.
Ooh, amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're a south sider.
I'm so really
a South
Sider.
Yeah. I'm up in the
South Side. Englewood. Forget y'all. I'm a North Sider, y'all. Okay. North Side, Evanston. Hey.
The heart of Englewood.
All South Side matters. All South Side matter.
And the North Side
all
matters.
All South Side
too.
Matter. Yeah.
Shout out E Town.
Yeah. It's all love. We all eat Garrett's popcorn
and Portillo's
and everything. It's all love. I just think the energy and the vibe of just being in Chicago is no place like it.
Thank you.
You know, it's no place like it. So
X.
I'm so glad to be a Chicagoan. You know? But South, shout out to the South Side, though. 87, all day. Stony Island. You know we're going to get our last words in. That's cute. I mean, yeah, the South Side.
Yes, yes. And I know
Jennifer
that...
Hudson, comment.
There you go.
What?
There you
all go. Of the great.
And I know you've been in quite a few of, shout out to Christopher Nolan, quite a few of his movies. Yes. Great, amazing director.
He is phenomenal.
Yes.
I had the privilege of working with him on a couple of films, Professor Mag, mm-hmm. and 72 Hours.
Mm-hmm.
And the storytelling. He has a gift.
Yep.
And I honor that gift that he has because it's not a lot of people who have the gift like he does as a filmmaker.
Right.
So he's helped me a lot, you know, and shout out to him. Mark Harris.
Yes. Yes.
But then we want to say shout out to like George Tillman and people like, you know, because there's a lot of great Chicagoans that came out of here and that are doing great things.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
And I want to get into that realm. So recently I joined the Producers Guild of America.
Okay.
So
congrats.
Thank you. Awesome. So I am looking for scripts and love the art of storytelling. So that's what's going on with me. Let me sit up straight. This is getting real. This is what's going to go on in 2023. The writing part too. I've been writing a lot of things.
Okay.
Got some stuff going. Some deals trying to be made.
Hey, okay.
That's nice. You know, cause I'm trying to figure out. I listen to people and you guys tell me, seriously, in all honesty, because I'm confused myself. Like, some people say they like me better in drama. Some people say they like me better in comedy.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm trying to write toward what people say they like, you know, to see from me. So right now I'm like, comedy, drama, comedy, drama. Then I'm like, dramedy. So
there you go.
There you go, right there.
Dramedy.
Yeah, yep. I like you in both. From what I've seen, I like you in both.
Yes.
You're really funny.
Thank you.
With the taco thing.
Okay, there's a story behind that. I don't even know what the story is. I just blurt stuff out. So in the movie in Hyde Park, that wasn't in the script. But at the audience feedback was great yesterday. Uh-huh. They were like, we like the taco line. I was like, taco line? What? Like, what's tacos? What's in my tacos for? And it wasn't in there.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I just said, I just want some tacos. I think in my head, I just blurt. You know how you guys talk? You think something and it comes out. And they was talking so much in the scene. I was like, I do something about tacos. Do they make tacos? I want some tacos or whatever. So that was just me being honest. Because I really do like tacos. Well,
hey, I love me some tacos too.
I love tacos.
And you also have a foundation. Let's talk about that.
Yes, my foundation. Thank you for bringing that up.
Sure.
It's true and near and dear to my heart. It's called the Erica Hubbard Foundation.
Mm-hmm.
And if anybody wants more information, it's on Instagram, the_Erica_Hubbard_Foundation.
Sure.
And or go to the website.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see all the stuff that I'm trying to do and doing, volunteering with at-risk youth in the community. So there's,
amazing.
You know, growing up in Chicago, sometimes a lot of kids don't have access to things.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Access to mentorship.
Mm-hmm.
You know, somebody give them encouraging words.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to mentor the kids, and then also I give scholarships away.
Oh, that's amazing.
To at-risk kids that need help, financial help going to college, you know, because college is expensive.
Mm-hmm.
They need, you know, stuff for books, you know, or some of them don't have adequate meal plans or half a meal plans or whatever. Or they may want to just, you know, go shopping and get the stress off of them for, you know, studying all week. And, you know, they want to, you know, just decompress. So I try to help the college kids financially.
That's amazing.
So far, next year, I'll be able to give my fourth scholarship away.
Hey,
so I'm excited. I gave a scholarship away to a girl going to Kennesaw State University, a girl going to Brown University, and then another girl who went to Texas.
Wow.
Yeah. So the one of the prerequisites is they just have to have a good GPA, graduating senior, and then they write an essay on how they think they can change the world through their major.
That's
so
good.
I'm glad you said that. I have two that are going to college next year.
Hey.
Yeah, twins.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you. So I'm going to go look on your foundation.
Yes. That's amazing. Yeah. That's amazing. So, Erica, how can people reach out to you? What are your social media handles? And
yes, my social media handle on Instagram is the number one, Erica, E-R-I-C-A Hubbard, H-U-B-B-A-R-D. Mm-hmm. So one Erica Hubbard. On Twitter, it's just Erica Hubbard.
Mm-hmm.
On Facebook, it's just Erica Hubbard. Snapchat, it's Erica Hubbard 100.
I love it because I'm from Chicago. I'm keeping it honest.
It's 100. And then what else? I'm on everything. LinkedIn, TikTok. It's Erica Hubbard, something. Just find me and I'll try to comment back or reach out to you if you guys need advice about the industry.
Yes.
Or you know, just hello and I'll say hi.
Hey, love it. I love it. Are you working on anything currently?
Yeah, I fly out tomorrow at 12 o'clock. So I'm packing in my head as I'm talking to you guys. Because I'm gone for 11 days and I haven't packed yet. So I'm going to throw some stuff in this luggage. Mm-hmm. But I'm working on a film called Assistant, and it's a dramedy.
Okay.
So,
congrats.
Thank you. I just finished a film in Atlanta.
Okay.
It's a vampire film. It's called Vampire Mist.
Mm-hmm.
And then I wrapped another film, a wedding film. So I'm all over the place. I'm vampire, getting married, I'm assisting people. I don't know.
I love it.
I just like the opportunity that's presented to me, you know, and I appreciate everybody that hits me up to be in their film. Sometimes I can't be in everybody's film.
Right.
No hard feelings, but I try to look for good quality scripts, and even if I can't do your film, keep me in mind for the next project.
Right.
We can work together because I like the art of collaborating.
There you go.
So it's a lot of talented people out here with scripts and stuff, and I applaud you. I commend you. Keep going. Continue success. And I just want to support people any way I can, whether it's me signing on as a producer or if it's me telling somebody else about the role and getting them an opportunity.
There you go.
Or if it's me, you know, being on your project, participating in your project. But we're going to get it done. Or if me praying about, you know, your success, you know, because I wish everybody to eat. I wish everybody success.
Thank you.
So there's some people out here that I pray for. They don't even know I'm praying for them, you know, actors and actresses, because I want everybody to rise.
There you go.
You know?
Awesome. I love it. So many gems dropped tonight.
I love it. I'm soaking
all over me. Girl, tell me about it. Amazing. Well, we congratulate
you.
We salute you. We wish you all the best on everything that you're working on now and everything that's coming in the future.
Thank you.
You are the bomb.
Oh, I appreciate that.
I love you. I'm your biggest fan. I've been following you for a long time.
I appreciate it on the scene.
Oh, yes. And, you know, we can't let you depart without a gift.
Oh, thank you.
So you get your on the scene. I will get you a mask. I ran out of my mask, but you get your on the scene.
I'm on the scene.
She is on the scene, y'all. definitely. You have to come back and follow up with us.
Okay.
We have some time. You know, because she's booked and busy, y'all. Seriously. But it was a pleasure to have you grace our platform.
Thank you so much for having me on the show, and I look forward to coming back.
Yes. We can't wait.
Awesome.
Can't wait. Any parting words, Sandra?
Thank you so much for all the gems that you gave.
Yes.
Duly noted on everything.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, I'm a big fan of yours, and I can't wait to see the vampire assist and
thank you.
The wedding.
Thank you.
Yes. And one more thing I have to say. It was just amazing watching her work, because I was in Hyde Park with her, and let me tell you, just watching her do her thing was amazing. Learned so much.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you guys.
We love
you. I love you, Chicagoans.
We love you, Erica.
I love y'all, Chicagoans.
Chicagoans are real.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. We are real genuine.
Yeah.
Yes.
We some lovable people.
We are. We sure are. Definitely.
Yeah.
And big supporters.
Yeah.
So, you guys, that's it for another dope episode of On the Scene. Please hang out with us next week for the rest of the night. Peace out.
Lie to me.
Lie?
You told me you left Sarah at the club at 2 a.m.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Jeff Marshall says you're on his boat with her until 5 a.m. Is that true?
We totally broke the behavior contract. Drinking, popping pills, hanging with those guys. I was afraid they wouldn't let me go on the Bahamas trip.
Where'd you go after the boat?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Tina.
Really? I was so drunk, I passed out somewhere. When I woke up, Sarah was gone. I knew I couldn't call you guys till my buzz wore off.
Well, that cost us a lot of time.
And maybe Sarah's life.
Don't you think I know that?
We need your help, Tina, right now.
How? Hi, I'm Yvette.
Oh, okay. Come on in. Okay, so I have some chicken baking in the oven. Just take it out in about 20 minutes. Chris and Drew are going to watch the basketball game.
What am I going to do while Chris and Drew are watching a basketball game?
Well, you can hang with me. I'll show you how to do French braids.
Okay.
And Yvette, I left the number to the restaurant by the phone. Now, call me if anything goes wrong, okay?
Everything's going to be fine. Chris, I got to go.
What do you mean you got to go?
I got something I got to do.
You are doing something.
Well, you stayed with your brother and sister before, right?
Yeah, but that's only during the day.
You'll be fine. I'll be right back.